I'm doing surgery again, but this time I'm doing it in an ambulance. That seems safe. Hello everybody, I am Kindly Keyin and welcome back to Surgeon Simulator. I have hands in VR. We did the heart transplant in the ambulance, so I guess now it's time to do a bit of a kidney transplant. Seems easy enough. Let's do it. Begin operation. Bring it on, ambulance. Hello, Bob. It's good to see you. Don't worry, I'm a professional, and I'm holding a drill upside down. Or am I holding it the right way? Maybe this is the way that you're supposed to hold it, and all other surgeons are doing it wrong. Did you ever think about that, Bob? I bet you didn't. Anyways, I'm just gonna drill out some of these bone shards, you know, as you do, and there you go, just removing some of the ribs oh so delicately as I hold the drill like I'm a cool guy. I think that's good enough, but I actually have no idea. Should we get all the little bits of bone out? Probably. But is getting all these little bone shards that important? I mean, they're already in your body, why not just keep them there, right, Bob? Right, buddy? Right, buddy, old pal? Okay, I don't know why I'm slapping him on the face like that. I probably shouldn't do that. Okay, what is next? I actually am not sure. Do I need to take out all of his guts? I guess I do. And I have the perfect tool for it, a clipboard. Actually, no, I'm not gonna use the clipboard, but I am tempted to use the laser. The laser is always a bad idea. It's probably going to cause some issues for Bob. And as I'm talking to you guys, I might be lighting Bob on fire. Bob's a real trooper, so don't worry about him. Let's see if we can cut some stuff with this laser. This is just a terrible idea. Okay, Bob, you're not looking so good. I think I need to give you the green one, right? Is that the one? Yeah, that's the green one. Okay, keep that one handy. Okay, we need to cut right here. Okay, all right. Did we get the large intestine? No, we still got more cutting to do, it appears. I'm not sure exactly where to cut, but don't worry, I am a professional, and I've been trained to do exactly what I'm doing right now. Actually, I've never spent a day in training on how to be a surgeon. Don't tell Bob that! Okay, let's just move along, shall we? How do I get this part out? Wait, can I get his... Wait, well, no, that's his liver. We're replacing his kidneys, right? Hold on, let me get this guy open. Let's see. Yay, look at those little beans. Delicious. Put those in a bean casserole. Don't do that. That's disgusting. Okay, none of these bits are moving. I'm not sure, like, what's going on with the large intestine? What's the issue here? Why can't I remove the large intestine? Maybe I need, you know what? Maybe if I get that little bit right there, come on. Yeah, look at that. All right, I'm a professional. Here you go, Bob. Oh, Bob, your small intestines may have ended up on the floor of the ambulance. That's okay, right? That's totally fine. That was all part of my master plan. Don't you even worry. How do I get this part out? Actually, do I need to get this part out? Maybe I don't. Oh my gosh! I think that his stomach just teleported into another planetary realm. I don't know what just happened to it. Oh, he's bleeding. Oh no. Oh no, it's not working anymore. The green solution! Maybe this one? Nope, shouldn't have done that. I think that made it worse. Okay, Bob, he might not make it. He might not make it. Okay, I really gotta remove his large intestine, but maybe right here? Oh, I did it! I did it! There you go. Okay, you hold on to those. Don't let them fall on the floor of the ambulance. It's very dirty. Who's driving this thing? Oh my gosh, you're like stopping and going and stopping. You need to get your eyes checked or something. All right, we got kidneys to get rid of. Okay, we cut out the nice little beans. There you go. Oh, jumping beans you got in there. No wonder we're getting rid of these things. They're too hoppity. Okay, there you go. Boom. Done. He's done. He is a master of surgery and therefore gets balloons to dance with. Drill versus balloon? Oh, gosh. Okay, that was awesome. Well done, Bob. You did all the hard work here. Let's be honest. I would call that a very successful surgery. Let's do brain surgery in a moving ambulance. Hello, Bob. Oh, man. This is awkward. We meet again, huh? All right. All right, buddy. You know what? I'm just gonna crack open that noggin of yours. Just very ever so gently. Look at this delicate touch I have with this very heavy hammer. And if I do end up doing any damage to your brain, look on the bright side. You're getting a new one, buddy. See? It's all working out. It's all gonna work out in the end. Oh, gosh! Okay, wow. I am way better at that than I thought. Look at that monitor right there. That is just 40 seconds in. I've already got his brain out of his head. Shards of bone are in his brain cavity, but no one really worries about that. Like I said, the bones are already in his body. Why get rid of them? Okay. So now, oh, careful, Bob. Careful. All right, wait, we need to cut the little, the brain stem. Is that what it's called? You don't want your doctor asking you what part of the body that they're actually working on, but I think that's what it's called, the brainstem. That seems like a good option to go with. Oh my gosh, my hands are going absolutely bonkers. I'm in the wrong spot. Ooh, Bob's not doing so good. Okay, maybe I spoke too soon when I said that I'm so good. Oh, Bob's dead. Let's just ignore that and try again. I don't know why my hands go so crazy when I get like really close to Bob, but something about his aura, his presence, it makes me nervous. What can I say? Anyways, let's get back to cracking, shall we? Very delicate, very gentle. Look at me go. Okay, I think we've removed enough. Oh, yes. Yes, we have. Okay, I have no idea where I'm supposed to cut, so maybe, do I have a laser in here? Who took my laser? What is this? Is this a highlighter? I don't know what this is. I really could have used that laser right now. Just being honest. All right, well, let's just try the scalpel yet again. Oh, that was amazing. Okay, what do we do with a brain, though, that we don't really need anymore? Okay, I guess we just throw it out the door. That works. All right, new brain. Here it comes, Bob. Just need to grab that jar and just dump it out. That's how you typically handle potato chips and also brains. They're pretty much the same thing. And then you just pop it right down there, nice and backwards too. Perfect. Oh, don't mind me just doing eye surgery in the ambulance. There's eyeballs all over the place. That's fine. We're just gonna cut these guys out and give him new ones and he'll be perfectly fine. We're gonna give Bob a blue eye and an eight ball. And there you go, A++. Oh man, I'm getting good at this. All right, the final ambulance surgery, teeth transplant. Okay, I've done a great job of removing Bob's beautiful yet disgusting teeth. However, I can't get the new teeth. I can't pick them up. I just can't pick up the new teeth. What's going on? I made a terrible mistake. I'm sorry, Bob. You're not getting new teeth today. I'm gonna try a new technique. I'm just gonna pour the teeth into his mouth.
Nope.
I don't think that worked. Bob, where did those teeth go? Wait, give me the tooth. Give me the tooth. Oh, I had it. Oh, I got it. There's your new tooth. Wait, is that your old tooth? That's your old gross tooth, Bob. I am pouring the teeth into his mouth, and I think it kind of is working, actually. Because I literally cannot pick up these teeth. It's impossible. I probably should have tried this from the beginning. You could just use tweezers to... Yeah, okay. I feel dumb now. I probably should have just done that from the start, but there you go. I got an A++ because I'm the world's greatest dentist who doesn't know how to actually use his dental tools. Okay, so now that we've completed all of the levels in both the operating room and in the ambulance, we can now access a new area. And you probably already know where it is, but in order to do that, we gotta get this floppy disk. So we take this guy, and keep in mind, this only shows up after you've completed all of the levels that we've completed, and then we should be able to pop that in there. And Nigel, we've been watching your performance. We require your services in a special mission. By inserting this disk, you have agreed to come and help us, and an agent will be picking you up immediately. What? The agent? Yeah, okay. Yep. We are performing surgery in outer space now. This is actually so insane. Oh my gosh. Everything is floating. This is absurd. We need to do heart surgery. Oh, look, it's Earth. Oh, my goodness. Are we replacing this man's heart? I think we are. I think we're doing all the same transplants, surgeries that we did before. But this time in zero G. Oh, gosh. Okay, don't get hit by this. There are dangerous syringes just floating out in the open. That seems really bad. Okay, we got to get to work on this guy. Get these pills out of here. Oh, that is so cool. Actually, what is... Can I... Oh, what? Oh, I can change the gravity in the room. I did not realize I could do that. Okay, what does this do? Does this change the gravity left to right? It does. It totally does. Oh, gosh. Okay, everything is now on that side of the room, including Bob's heart. Let's just ignore that for now, I guess. Bob, I'm gonna need that hammer that's over there. Okay, don't mind me, buddy. Okay, let's get this guy's ribs open, shall we? Just need to very gently remove his ribs in zero G. This is so cool. Oh gosh, the bone is getting into my face. There's bone chunks flying all over the place, but on the bright side, it makes it very easy to, you know, keep his chest cavity nice and clean. Everything just floats out of it. Okay, so I've got a whole bunch of tools on the floor, which is probably not a great place to keep them, but we're in outer space, so, you know, normal rules don't apply. I have two options to get access to my tools. I can actually physically reach down and pick them up. Who wants to do that? We're in outer space. So instead, I'm going to change the gravity to go up, and I'm going to bring everything back to me. Oh my gosh. Okay, I need you. I got the scalpel. Caught it straight out of the sky. That was amazing. All right, so let's cut out Bob's stomach. There we go. You don't need this anymore. I'm going to throw it to that side. Oh my goodness, that's incredible. Just throw it over there. There, just keep all of his organs on that side of this strange space capsule that we're in. Okay, I kind of forget where I need to cut. Is it here? Okay, yep, and then there. Right, yep, no. I don't think I'm getting it quite right. Oh, I think I'm killing him. Where's his monitor? How do I... Oh, do I need... Oh, yeah. Yeah, he's not doing so good. Oh, well. Let's just continue on, shall we? Oh, we did it! We did it! Okay, put the bad heart over there. Where's the good heart? Good heart? Oh, no. Where's the good heart, Bob? Where'd you put it? Okay, I'm gonna need to bring everything back over here. Oh, please, please, good heart, where are you? Is that the good heart? Oh, I'm gonna try to catch it. Right out of the sky, right out of the sky. Oh, look at that, Bob. Slam dunk. Just dunk it. Is that the good heart? That's the good heart, right? Yeah! Space surgery is actually awesome. Okay, I'm not gonna lie. This was actually amazing. Doing the surgery in zero G takes this to the next level for sure. Let me know what you guys think. There's still more levels that we need to do. In fact, if I go back to the main menu, as you can see, we have all the surgeries that we have done in the past, but we need to do them in outer space, obviously. And then there's like a star situation. I'm not sure how to unlock that, but maybe once we complete all of these levels, we'll know more. Let me know if you guys want to see more Surgeon Simulator. I'm having just a fantastic time. This game is a ton of fun and it's so goofy. But that's gonna do it for this episode. If you guys enjoyed it, I'm just gonna wave my hands around and you can hit the like button. If I knew how to put my thumb up, I would. That's kind of there. Yeah, yeah, hit the like button. See, it's a thumb up, sort of. But as always, thank you guys for watching. And I'll see you guys next time. Let's go back to space, I guess.